Hello children, let me welcome you to the Virtual Training Center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. My name is Shraddha teacher. Children, we are in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic, isn't it? Because of that, we are not able to go to school. But that doesn't mean that we are going to stop learning. We are going to meet here regularly through the Virtual Training Center to learn many lessons in EVS. So come on, let's go to a lesson in EVS. So children, the lesson that we will do today is a lesson in standard 3rd EVS. It is lesson number 8 from your EVS textbook, and the name of the lesson is Our Need for Water. Now, whenever you think about water, children, we always think about water in a bottle. Isn't it? Our mummy fills up water in the bottle and she keeps it in the fridge for us to drink sometimes. We also think about the water that we drink from a glass. So the moment I say water, we always think about these kind of images regarding water. Water in a bottle, water in a glass, etc. Some of us who have gone to beaches for picnics might also think about the sea and the water present in the sea. Or if you are living in a village, you might think about the river which is there in the village, which is a source of water for you. So when we talk about water, we always think about water on the outside. Isn't it? The bottle of water, the glass of water, water coming from the tap, water in a bucket in your house, water in the sea, water in the river, rain water, etc. But children, do you know, are you aware that even the human body, that is our body, is composed of water? A major part of the human body is composed of water. That means water is not just water in the glass and water in the bottle, but water is also a part of our human body. And therefore, our need for water is something which is very, very important, isn't it? So let us talk about water and its importance or its need for us. So let us look at some beautiful images now. So see, what is this? This is a child like you who is a little sad, and what is happening? This child is crying, and when the child is crying, what can you see? You can see a drop of water coming out of her or his eye, isn't it? What is this drop of water called, children? It is called as a tear. So tears which come out of our eye is also a form of water. And where is it coming from? It is coming from your eye. And your eyes are a part of your body, isn't it? Look at the next example of water in our body. So have you ever seen this kind of a tamarind? Imli, we call it. Imli, sometimes when we see kairi, or sometimes when we see the pani puri, isn't it? What happens to our mouth? Our mouth starts watering. And what is that water called? It is called saliva. So the water which is there in your mouth is called saliva. The water which comes out of your eyes is called tears. So can you see how water is present in our body in various forms, isn't it? Let us look at the next one now. See what is happening to these people. There is water flowing from his nose. Isn't it? Have you experienced this, children? During the rainy season, when you get wet, you get a cold. Okay, you start coughing and then your nose starts running. Now your nose starts running doesn't mean that your nose gets off your body and it starts running. It means that water starts coming out of your nose. So this water which comes from your nose is also a part of the water in your body, isn't it? Let us look at something else now. This happens to us, isn't it? When we are sometimes sharpening our pencil using a blade instead of a sharpener. Or when your mummy gives you work to cut some onions or to cut some tomatoes, and if you're not careful, you cut your hand by mistake. And what comes out? Blood comes out of your finger. Now, blood is also a kind of water, isn't it? Which comes out of your body. So see, water is present in our body in the form of tears, in the form of saliva, in the form of blood, etc. So can you see how water is a very important part of our body also, isn't it? So water is there in our body in various forms. All right. Now let us move on and see whether water is present in vegetables and fruits also. So what is this boy doing? There is a cucumber in front of him. A cucumber means you call it kheera, or you also call it kakdi. Isn't it? So when you grate the kakdi, when you do kaddukas to the kakdi, and when you press it, see what comes out of the kakdi, what comes out of the cucumber? Water comes out. That means there is water in cucumber also. Likewise, there is water in lemons. Okay? Can you see she's squeezing the lemon and water is coming out of the lemon? Lemon juice. So in lemons also there is water in the form of juice. In oranges there is water in the form of juice. Can you see? She has cut the orange into two halves, and one half she has held it over the juicer. And there is juice coming out of the orange. So you will see that water is present in a number of fruits and vegetables also. Not only in the human body, but also in fruits and vegetables. So can you think of any other vegetable or fruit which has got a lot of water? So think about it, and that is one part of your assignment for today. Okay? Now, let us move on and let us see what happens when you do not have enough water in your body. When you do not drink enough water, what happens? You feel thirsty. Thirsty means what? Your throat starts drying up and you feel very uncomfortable. Isn't it? When it is very hot also, you feel very uncomfortable. And then what do? When you drink water, you become okay. Alright? So when your body needs water, we need water for a lot of functions in our body. So when your body needs water, how does it tell you that it needs water? By telling you that you are thirsty. Isn't it? So now let us look at the different needs of water in your body. So see, water forms saliva. I just now told you about saliva. When we think about some food which is very tasty, which you like a lot, what happens? Your mouth starts watering. That is called saliva. Water throws out the waste matter from your body. Okay? Water helps to keep your joints healthy. Water also allows proper function of the brain. Sometimes you will see that your head starts aching. You get a lot of headache. But then you need not have a tablet all the time. Sometimes you do not drink enough water. That is why also your head can ache. Okay? So whenever your head aches the next time, drink a glass of water and see whether it makes a difference. It allows the cells in your body also to grow. Okay? So this is the uses of water in our body. Let us look at some of them in detail now. So water keeps the blood in our body also thin. Alright, now you know children that blood has to flow throughout our body. If blood does not flow throughout our body will not get oxygen and then we will die. So if the blood has to flow properly, it has to be thin. isn't it? Sometimes when people's blood becomes thick, na, they get a heart attack and they die. Okay, so it is water which helps to keep the blood thin. It keeps the blood watery. You will learn more about this in the higher classes. Okay, so for now it is important for us to know that blood keeps thin, the blood remains thin if you drink enough water. When you drink enough water, digestion also takes place properly. Now children, you must have seen your mummy grinding masala in the mixer. So when she puts only the masala in the mixer and she tries to grind, does the mixer work properly? No, isn't it? So what does she do? She adds some water. So in the same way, water helps to digest the food that we eat. You will also see that water helps to remove the waste matter from our body. Now, what is the waste matter which is there in our body? In the body of human beings as well as the body of animals, you will see that the waste matter is removed in the form of urine and stool. Okay, so if you have to remove all this waste from your body, you should drink water properly. See this? Animals also need water. You must have seen a dog doing susu, na? So a dog urinates, isn't it? So that is also waste matter. Just like human beings, the waste matter is thrown out of the dog's body also, out of the cat's body also, out of the lion's body also, out of the elephant's body also. Isn't it? So, to throw waste matter out of the body of human beings or animals, you need to drink enough water. So, along with urination, the water is thrown out in the form of stool also. So, see here, a dog passing stool. So if the dog has to pass a stool, that is if it has to throw the waste matter out of its body, it drinks a lot of water. It needs to drink a lot of water. And the same goes for us human beings also. Okay, if we have to throw the waste matter out of our body, we will have to drink a lot of water. Let us move on now and let us look at some animals drinking water. See the dog. See how the dog drinks water. Can you see? We can hold a glass in our hand and drink water. See how the dog is drinking water using its tongue. Okay. There are other animals also which drink water. See the horse drinking water. Now, not only the domestic animals, children, but wild animals also need to drink water. See, this is a tiger drinking water. It is looking at you also, okay? So be very careful, all right? And then you will see that even tiny animals like a snail needs to drink water. So whether it is a domestic animal, whether it is a wild animal, whether it is a big animal or a small animal, all of them need to drink water in order to live. Isn't it? So wasn't it interesting? Now, see, look at this. People who keep animals at home, that is, if you have a dog at home, you will give the dog water to drink. But other animals like the ant, the honeybee, the crab, the scorpion, and so many other animals like birds, sparrows, ducks, all these animals also need water. We do not give them water to drink, but they drink water from nature. Okay? And sometimes you must have seen people go on these safaris. Can you see those people in the jeep? They go on safaris in the jungle. And where do these people take them, you know? They take them near the water hole. So what is a water hole, children? A water hole is like a pond or a small lake in the jungle where animals go to drink water. So people know that animals will come here to drink water. That is the reason that in a safari, people go near these water holes to spot these animals. Because these wild animals require water. When they feel thirsty, they come to these water holes to drink water. Okay? Now let us move on and talk about human beings. So see, human beings, what all these people are doing here, this is an image from the textbook. Now let us look at them and let us try and understand what all they are doing. So these two aunties here, these two kakus, they are washing their clothes here, isn't it? This uncle or this kaka here is washing his cow. Okay, you will see these people, this lady, the boy, carrying water away from this place. So they will take this water home and there they will wash some vessels or they will cook using this water. You will also see these animals are drinking water from there. Okay, the goats are drinking water from this river. And of course, small and naughty children like you playing in the river water. So see how water is very, very essential for us. Not only for us, but also for our animals. We bathe them, we give them water to drink. And for our own use also, we make use of water to wash clothes, to wash vessels, to have a bath, etc. Okay, so see, look at this one more image from your textbook. So people need water not only for drinking, but also for cooking and for cleaning. Cleaning what? Cleaning our own bodies, cleaning our clothes. Okay, cleaning our vessels. Now, not only inside the house, but also outside. For example, look at this shetkari or this farmer. He needs water, isn't it? To water his plants in the field. And also people who have very big companies or factories, they also need water. So water is very, very important for our lives. So did you understand, children, why we need water? Now it is not only human beings and animals that need water, but also plants need water to grow. See, if you keep watering a plant, it will grow beautifully. All right? See here, let us look at the small experiment from your textbook. So we know that plants need water to grow well. So for example, we have taken two plants here, the same kind of plant, okay? The same height and the same type of plant. So let us call one plant as plant 1 and the other one as plant 2. So let us water plant 1 now. Okay, so we will give plant 1 a lot of water. We will water it regularly. And plant number 2, we will be little wicked towards this plant. We will not give it any water to drink. After some days, what will you see? You will see that plant number 1 is growing well. Whereas look at plant number 2, the poor plant has withered away. Withered away means you are not giving it water to drink, isn't it? The plant is getting thirsty, but you're still not giving it water to drink. And that is the reason that the plant has withered away. That means it will die very soon. Okay? So plants also need water to grow. Now you have some potted plants at home. Many of us, we have. Sometimes if you are living in a village, then you have a big garden around your house. But we are poor people who live in cities. We do not have that much space, isn't it? So we have these small kind of potted plants in our gallery, in our terrace, etc. How do you water these plants, children? You water them regularly, daily, in the morning or in the evening, using a can, using a bucket, etc. Now, people who have farms, the farmers, what do? They have these kind of machines to water their plants, to water their crops. Okay, see here, one more machine. These are all sprinklers. But then you must have seen that it is the plants that are there in the pots and that are there in the fields that are watered by us. We give them water. What about these plants that grow in the jungle? When we were talking about animals, also we discussed that animals who are pets in our homes, for example, our doggy, our cat, we give them water. But there are various other animals like the snail, like the crocodile, etc., which drink water from outside, isn't it? So what about the plant in these jungle? How do they get water from? They get water from the rain. So when it rains, the plants get lots and lots of water and they continue to grow. Okay? So that means not only the plants which are there in your home, that is your potted plants or your crops, but also the plants in the jungle need water. Okay? And how do these plants use this water? Water seeps into the soil and the roots of the plants absorb it. Can you see? Water which comes in the form of rain, or water which you pour, it goes into the soil, and from the soil it mixes up in the soil, and then it is pulled up by these plants using the root. Okay, so that is how water is used by these plants in order to grow well. So not only animals, not only human beings, but also plants need water to grow well. Now, there are some plants, children, which are found only in water. For example, see, this is one kind of a plant called as the bulrush. So this plant, you will find it only in water. Okay, if you pluck this plant from water and if you try to put it in soil, this plant will die. So there are certain plants which grow only in water. See, look at this one more plant which grows in water. It is called as the water hyacinth. All right, now this image must not be clear to you. So you see how this flower looks from close. See, this flower you must have seen, na? So this is a water hyacinth. So this plant also can grow only in water. If you pull it out of water and if you like it very much and you say, okay, this is very beautiful, this flower is very pretty, let me pull it out of water and let me take it home and plant it in a pot, it will die there. It will not live there. Okay, so these are some water plants. Let us look at some more water plants. See, you must have all seen this plant and this beautiful flower. This is a lotus. So lotuses are flowers or plants which grow only in water. You cannot pluck it from water and try to plant it in soil. Then see, this is one more. This is called as the water chestnut. You also call it as the singada. You must have seen this. Okay, this is a water chestnut. Now in the rainy season, when the rainy season starts getting over, you will see people loaded carts of the singada or this water chestnut. Okay, people who are having upvas, people who do fast, they also eat this thing. So these are all plants which grow in water. So we learned so much about water today, and we also learned that everyone should take care to keep the public sources of water clean, and it is our responsibility to do it. Okay, so public source of water means lakes, etc. You should try to keep it clean. And also remember, as children, you should see that you never waste water. So what should you do to not waste water? In case there is a dripping tap in your home. Have you seen these kind of dripping taps, children? Sometimes not only in your home, at our school also. We see that even if you have turned off the tap very tightly, but still it keeps on dripping. What is happening here? Water is being wasted. Okay, so along with keeping water clean, we should also see that we do not waste it. So what can we do at our level? We can see that no taps drip. Okay, so much of water goes waste. Along with that, you should also see that you do not leave these taps running. There are some people, children, who are a little careless. They open the tap to see whether there is water, and then they forget to turn the tap off, or they forget to turn or close the tap. Now what happens is, later when water comes, the water starts going waste. So you should be very careful that when you put on a tap, always put it off. Okay, otherwise you will be wasting a lot of water, which is very, very bad. Some people also have the habit of simply wasting water. See, look, what is this man doing? He's simply wasting water, isn't it? Unnecessarily, he's just wasting water. So should you do all this? Not at all, because water is very, very important and we need water, and it is a very important need in our life. Okay, so we talked about need for water in today's lesson. We talked about how water is important for us and how it is an important part of our body also. We also talked about the fact that not only human beings, but animals and plants also need water to grow well. We saw that our body needs water in order to keep our blood thin and also in order to eliminate the waste matter from our bodies. So that was about the need for water. So children, now you have watched the video. So after you watch the video now, you will have to complete a few simple tasks. Now you might have watched the video on your computers or your laptops or your mobile phones. Now after you watch the video, what will you do? You will please go to the description box which is given below the video. So what is the description box? See, the description box looks like this. All right. And after you go to the description box, you will see that there are a few questions there. Now, what are these questions about? These questions are about the lesson that we just learned or the video that you just watched. So what will you do? You will think back properly about the lesson and you will try and answer these questions and note down the answers in your notebook if you want. Okay? After that, we have another task waiting. You will also click on the link which you will find in the description box to fill up the Google form. So now what is the Google form, children? It is nothing but a simple form. There are a few simple questions there about the video which you just saw and also about yourself. So these are the tasks now that you will have to complete after you watch each video. So children, wasn't that a very interesting lesson? I'm sure you learned a lot of new things in this lesson. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my video so that you will get to see all the videos which I keep posting regularly.